In today's video, we continue our retelling of the story of the evolution of the Starship at the second part of a two-video series. This is all about the recent successes and the future of SpaceX's Starship aircraft, a shining hope for mankind's drive to reach the stars. Welcome, dear viewers. Today, we will take a detailed look into the prototype testing history and the recent development timeline of the Starship. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. We left off the previous part of the video with the transformation of the IFR project into the Starship project, which was announced concurrently with plans for a lunar circumnavigation mission titled #DearMoon. In line with being able to launch the first privately handed space flight to the moon, SpaceX has been hard at work attempting to get working prototypes finished and delivered to finality. On the 8th of December 2018, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk announced that the company would undertake a counterintuitive new design approach for the early testing phase. This counterintuitive new design approach was later revealed on 23rd December 2018 to be the Starhopper spacecraft, which had been in construction for several weeks by that time. This Starhopper spacecraft was designed first and foremost with the intent of testing launch dynamics with the decision to use stainless steel for the Starship. Starhopper had a body built for austenitic stainless steel. According to Elon Musk, the reason for choosing stainless steel was that at cryogenic temperatures, the strength is boosted by 50. Aside from that, austenitic stainless steel has a very high melting point. This means that the side of the Starship, or in this case, the Starhopper facing away from the Earth during re-entry, would need no insulation. The design also had a double-wall stainless steel kin, which allowed for the much hotter side facing the Earth to be cooled by allowing water to flow through designed pores. Outfitted with a single engine for propulsion, the Starhopper was also intended to test and develop by landing and low-altitude control mechanics and algorithms. Further Starhopper prototypes were being concurrently built as the initial Starhopper was preparing to fly. These further prototypes were the Starhopper Mark I and the Starhopper Mark II. Starhopper took off in July 2019, simulating booster stages for a total climb of 150 meters and then safely landing 100 meters from the launch pad, marking the first use of the Raptor engine. The Starhopper Mark I and Mark II vehicles were larger than the original Starhopper, now sporting a design closer to the Starship concept, and they were powered by three Raptor engines. Only the MK-1 would go on to face tests after its reveal in September of 2019. During the day of testing on the 20th of November 2019, the spacecraft exploded during the tank pressure testing phase. The pressure testing phase was intended to enable scientists to see how well the Starhopper stainless steel body and the Raptor engine's liquid methane fuel could handle temperature conditions in space. Lack of air in space exerts pressure in space, and the cryogenic testing conditions were meant to test those in space. SpaceX's reaction to the explosion was to simply shrug it off, learn what could be learned from it, and move on with new prototypes. Later onwards, however, SpaceX decided that they were ready to move on with the testing of the intended Starship design. It is not entirely clear to the wider public as to why SpaceX felt very confident about moving onwards with the main Starship design testing. However, it can be reasonably assumed that the data gained from the pressure testing failure of the MK-1 indicated to SpaceX that certain adjustments in the right direction could greatly help speed up the progress if done right. SpaceX initially stated on the same day of the test failure that SpaceX would skip developing the MK-1 and MK-2 and move on to the Starhopper MK-3 and MK-4. By the end of October 2019, however, it became apparent that work on both the MK-3 and MK-4 paused in Florida. SpaceX announced in December 2019 that the Starhopper MK-3 would be renamed Starship SN-1, and the final design concept of the Starship would begin to experience testing. Elon Musk would go on to explain that there had been a change in the production of Starship and minor design improvements would continue. Starship prototypes from SN1 onwards would have TIP-TIG welding compared to FLUX core welding, would guarantee stronger joints and a 20% mass reduction. Testing of prototypes went ahead in January 2020 with SN1 and SN2. Pressurization tests were undertaken on both these prototypes, which SN1 failed on 28 February 2020 due to a design flaw in the fuel tank. The lesson learned from the destruction of SN1 was later used to make the testing of the SN2 a success when it underwent the same cryogenic pressure testing on the 8th of March, 2020. The next two Starship prototypes that SpaceX came out with were the SN3 and SN4 prototypes. Elon Musk mentioned that the SN3 would be used for testing static fire tests and short hops, while SN4 would be used for testing longer flights into the atmosphere and far above. SN3 was, however, destroyed during testing on the 3rd of April 2020. The cause was revealed to be an error in setting the testing configurations, which caused pressure loss and structural failure. SN4, on the other hand, safely passed cryogenic pressure testing on the 26th of April 2020, and then passed two static fire tests on the 5th of May 2020 and the 7th of May 2020. The SN4's good fortune would not last long, however, as a third test firing of the engine led to the methane fuel piping system being shaken loose, causing a fire. Significant damage to the fuselage would delay progress until 29th May 2020, when the SN4 detonated due to a malfunction of the ground support equipment during another static fire test of the engine. At this point, any other aerospace company would have likely given up, but SpaceX soldiered on to make a working Starship prototype. Starship prototypes, SN5 and SN6, were ready by the 30th of July, 2020. SN5 would go on to complete a 150-meter flight on the 4th of August, 2020, and SN6 would go on to complete a static fire test on 24th of August, 2020, and would follow it up with a 150-meter hop on the 3rd of September, 2020. The SN5 and SN6 prototypes were the most successful prototypes at the time, but the SN6 would not make it to space due to it being powered only by a single engine. Testing of the SN7 would not make any significant impact on the entire design process timeline of the Starship, but it was important in influencing the decision to switch to 304L stainless steel. It underwent destructive cryogenic pressure testing to figure out the optimal pressure ceiling of future prototypes on 15th June 2020 and 23rd June 2020. On the 9th of December 2020, SpaceX would launch their most successful prototype till date, the SN8. The SN8 prototype's design had improved on top of the previous versions, as it included a nose cone fairing, aerodynamic control surface, and three Raptor engines. The SN8 prototype was meant to test the Starship's ability to safely return to land after a launch. Thus, the stakes were high. Elon Musk himself mentioned that the odds of a safe landing stood at one-third. The spacecraft launched and ascended into the skies as SpaceX staff watched from below. It flew upwards to a distance of 12.5 kilometers from the ground and then began its descent. Reorientation of the craft and the belly flop maneuver, in which the craft descends horizontally to bleed off speed, were all completely successful. The craft even shot itself upwards to complete the landing, but it impacted the ground with too much velocity, exploding as a result. Sounds like a failure, right? You would be wrong. Elon Musk immediately tweeted, "Mars, here we come." Even though the prototype exploded upon final impact, it proved that the rocket could in fact come back down and complete all of its maneuvers as designed to do so. The SN8 prototype test is considered a partial success, but it is arguably the most important and impactful partial success experienced by any company testing out a rocket or any other vehicle. Now, SpaceX still has to go till the Starship SN20, and they are currently readying up the SN9 for a flight test. It is already undergoing hop tests, and these tests have so far been successful. The future of the Starship is bright, and the SN8 was the first achievement to make that fact a reality. It is clear that the Starship is in humanity's best bet to reach the planets of the solar system and beyond. It has taken SpaceX a long time to realize this goal since the initial concept building in the 2000s and the first announcement of the project in 2012. To be able to accomplish such a feat of high engineering, a company has to make it a habit to constantly innovate, and only SpaceX could stand up to such a task. What do you think of Starship's evolutionary journey throughout the years? Are you excited for the new heights SpaceX aims to reach? Or are you more interested in the offerings of their competitors? If you like this video, you may also enjoy our full list on space exploration on our playlist that is shown in the end screen. And please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech.